Sorry, I said, so I'm sorry, Regina, what you said? No, I said, why did you really stop me other than, does it look like I'm? Well, what's your name?
Milton.
Milton, I'm Jamal.
Yeah, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah, nice to meet you.
Well, I'm gonna tell you, what do you, Milton, forgive me if I repeat, I got nerve damage to my head a little bit, okay? Well, I'm not going to church, just to be honest, does it really look like my attire is going to what the Bible calls whorehouses? Jeremiah 5:7? Okay, then, so that's what I'm saying, if you really want, if you really wanted to be honest, then, you know, just say, hey, you know, where you dress? Well, the Bible says, according to the book of Galatians, Jerusalem is the mother of us all, alright? What do you know about the Bible?
Well, I go to church a lot.
You do? Well, the Bible says in the book of Matthew, where two or three are gathered in my name, I am in the midst, so this is church, right?
Right. You know what I'm saying? You look like you might end up from New York. I used to live in New York.
Yeah, I was stationed up there for a little while. A little bit ex-military. Albany. And then in the Bronx as well.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So, I don't think, you know, what do you know about the Bible?
A lot. There's so much.
Okay, well, I'll just say, okay, you know everything. Not everything, but you
know. I know everything.
I'm just speaking very brief. My name is Jabbar Yasharala. That means broken spirit in Hebrew. And I can place it.
So you live in Georgia now?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Okay.
You married?
Well, let me finish. Okay. The Bible says that, you know about the slave ships and all that in the Bible?
Yeah, a little. And like I said, I just started getting back into it, you know, so, and, you know, I'm going to be honest about it.
Okay.
That hard open, ain't it?
No, it's left side. I got nerve damage to my left side, so it's kind of hard every now and then, all right?
Really?
A little bit of weak side there, but it's okay.
Really?
I got to keep it moving.
Yeah.
Well, listen, Milton. I'm going to be very brief. Let me look at my time. Like I said, my name is Jamal Yasharala. That means broken spirit in Hebrew. And I can trace my heritage all the way back to the tribe of Gad, the original natives of this land. According to the Bible, we are the Hebrews. I can bear witness. I can see. Well, let me just break it down. In the book of Deuteronomy, the Bible says that we go back into slavery on slave ships. The nation that would do this would be swift as the eagle flying. We're going to back in the money to the eagle and the pyramid, right? Egypt is a Greek term that means bondage. All right? So-called, go to Genesis 25th chapter, the 27th chapter around that time, talks about the fraternal twins, Jacob and Esau and Jacob. The Bible calls Esau red, okay? That was of his attributes, and plus he sold his birthright for some red pottage. Mm-hmm. So he became Edom, the so-called modern day European. It's our fraternal twin brother, all right? You go to Solomon 1 and 5, he says, I am black, but come to turn. I am black, but beautiful. Go to Acts 13:1, you can see that the prophet and the teacher told me. I was aware of the spirit of the land since I was 8 years old. My forefather Gad was a seer, according to the book of Chronicles. So one of the curses in Deuteronomy 28 chapter is that we would serve our enemies, all right? So I left and I went to the military, running from my gift like Jonah and the whale. There are women in the Bible like me, Deborah, Anna, Miriam, even Mary Magdalene. You can see these are events. Didn't want to see it, all right? So in 98, a burst of light entered my body. 2006, he took me to hell and back. 2008, he told me a vision concerning this place. April 17, 2008, at 2 o'clock that night, the one that they called Jesus Christ took my whole house. He said, enough is enough. Still didn't want to hear it, so I put the pillow over my head.
That's time on the floor, bitch.
I put the pillow over my head. So in about 15 minutes in my sleep, I was awakened, and I was transformed from the crown of my head to the sole of my feet. I was brand new, and I was descending down into a building. That building had a window in it about 60 feet across, and I could see people through that window walking every day. So it was some things to know. He began to speak. The heavens rolled back as a scroll, and he began to speak, and that's when I looked up and said, Chicago would be the first to fall. He was so bright at this time, I couldn't see him. Well, I did see him in his vision, but I have seen the one that called Jesus Christ. He began to speak. He said, enough is enough. And he said, Chicago would be the first to fall. And I saw a mystery that obliterated Chicago on April 17th, this year, over 10 years ago. You know what's happening every day in Chicago?
No.
They call it Chirac because of they call it the murder capital because it's worse than Iraq. Worse than Iraq.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Not only that, when the pilgrims came here, one of the first places that they brought religion was to Chicago. The Bible defines religion according to James 1:27. He came back years later and lived in Jamestown, Virginia, where he's the last standing. I know you know what happened at Jamestown, Virginia, right?
Jamestown, Virginia. I told you I just get back in there, but be honest.
Oh, it's secular history. The Pilgrims, one of the first colonies, when they got here, they docked at Jamestown, Virginia, and they start slaughtering my tribe, the tribe of Gad, all the way to this place after Columbus hit. This place is called what? Columbus after Christopher Columbus. That's Isaiah 43:6, because you upheld the children of Israel and refused to let them go. Like I said, I got a slight trial because they tried to kill me on 85, almost 10 months ago. I have nerve damage to my head, 100 to 150 miles. Huh? No, I tried to dodge the prison twice. Paternal twin brother, he still hit me. That's all I knew, it wasn't an accident. All right, a bright light filled the car and slowed the impact down. The one they called Jesus Christ, and guided the car. And I've seen Michael the Archangel. He was there that day. That was the second time I've seen the Archangel, okay? So that was number 8. My life is almost complete. So I can bear witness that we are the Hebrews. He said this place would be up in smoke by 2019. Just about 2 weeks ago, when they called Jesus Christ, visited me, and he said, you got about 5 months. It's countdown. You ever heard of that so-called Hopi Indian prophecy? It's pagan. I don't deal with it because they had some insight, but they got it from the wrong individual, the Most High, the one they call Lucifer, that Most High, or Satan, okay? Adversary, it means adversary of the Most High. If you have all the correct information, that the prophecy in the book of Genesis that we will serve our enemies 400 years one last time. I use that because the Bible says that there is nothing new in the sun. Last but not least, you ever heard the term that my tribe was over here telling the so-called native Indians? That in native chant, Ahaya, because that's God's name in the Hebrew. Ahaya, Shah, Ahaya, his name, his son's name is Yeshaya. Yeshaya in the Hebrew. And who else will walk, right? Wawarak is the spirit. The Bible says, train up a child. Wawarak, good job. The Bible says, train up a child in the way that he should go. He says, apart from it. Jack, if I have a husband, the Bible says that we have to crucify the flesh sometimes. I have men tell me to quit doing what I'm doing. Even his dad. You understand? So you got to go. Because I got to follow the Most High and his
spirit.
What
you're doing when you quit doing
it. Prophesying. Speaking.
Nothing wrong with that.
Speaking.
Nothing wrong with that.
Exactly. I've been to hell and back, and you can't give an account of what I'm going to do. The Bible says in the last days that your enemies is going to be where? Your own house.
I've been in a lot of accidents since you say that. Motorcycles and cars.
You see that? You see what I'm saying? The Bible scares us for a reason. The Bible says time and chance have to be to us all. Milton, I don't know. You could be from the tribe of Gad. You could be from the tribe of Judah. You know, you have to do your research. Do you use YouTube, yeah. Milton?
Yeah.
Okay.
Right. And you so remind me of her. I can't believe that.
Well, you know what? The Bible says it could be the left side of the spirit is bearing witness, okay? That we are the Hebrews. That's all what it is, all right? Remember I told you? Matthew, where two or three are gathered in his name, he is in the midst. So, Milton, if you look up GOCC, I've gained the most 1,000 followers worldwide, but it's not about the followers. I know you know this simple question, Milton. Christ had how many disciples? I know
you're
I know everybody knows the so-called Christians.
You're sketching this, so you were going into the thing.
I know, because I told you my mind would get locked
I'm
up.
Tired.
There ain't nothing wrong with that. I'm saying nothing wrong. You're still a blessing to be here.
Well, listen, Milton. Christ, thank you. Christ had 12 disciples, and two of them did what? They betrayed. So it's not about the followers that I've gained them.
Yeah.
You understand that? Chicago, you follow the law, the commandments of the Most High, all right? And you look up Chicago prophecy,